The U.S. State Department ranks the Philippines as a tier one country, which meets minimum standards for eliminating human trafficking. State Department's annual report listed 30 countries in its tier one ranking. The Philippines, Singapore, and Taiwan were the three Asian areas in the report. The minimum standards covered in the tier one ranking are set by the U.S. Trafficking Victims Protection Act. The Philippines was first listed in the tier one in 2016. The State Department report praised the Philippines' drafting standard operating procedures to identify and monitor trafficking-related corruption cases. It also commends the establishment of a migrant workers department and the sentencing of nearly all convicted traffickers to significant prison terms. But the report faults the Philippine government for failing to vigorously probe labor trafficking crimes and to hold accountable officials complicit in the crimes. Philippine Migrant Workers Secretary Susan Ople welcomes the State Department findings. Ople is confident the country will keep its ranking under the Marcos administration.
The Philippine National Police on the defensive as it faces fresh allegations of misconduct. American Democrat Congresswoman Susan Wild earlier moved to limit U.S. assistance to the PNP because of human rights concerns. The U.S. had previously provided training and equipment to Philippine police. The PNP spokesperson calls the lawmaker's move unfortunate and insists the Philippine police force is a defender of human rights. The police official also says they welcome an investigation into the concerns raised in the U.S. Congress.
Kung may mga issue po ng human rights po, siguro it would be best for both countries na pareho pong nag-e-enjoy ng state sovereignty na hayaan po ang PNP kasama po ang ibang ahensya po ng government to address po yung mga issue po ng human rights.
President Marcos meets with his environment chief to discuss measures on preserving the country's natural resources. Marcos met Tony Yulo Loizaga in Manacanang Wednesday. They also looked into digitizing the Environment Department's database and systems. Their meeting came a day after Yulo Loizaga was sworn in by President Marcos.
New government appointees announced by Malacanang on Wednesday, Danilo Cruz has been named Director General of the Technical Education and Skills Development Authority, or TESDA. Cruz previously served as Undersecretary for Employment and Manpower at the Labor Department. Bowling legend and Hall of Famer Olivia Bongku is the new commissioner of the Philippine Sports Commission. Meanwhile, President Marcos has also appointed officials who will lead the attached agencies of the Transportation Department. They include the new heads of the Manila International Airport Authority and the Maritime Industry Authority. They have taken their oaths before Transport Chief Jaime Bautista.
President Marcos orders agriculture officials to work with the Customs Bureau and the legislative branch to fight vegetable smuggling and the illegal importation of agricultural products in the country. Marcos, who is concurrent agriculture secretary for now, emphasized the crucial role of coordinated efforts to curb these problems. The DA and the Customs Bureau have already launched joint efforts to weed out smuggled items in the market. The BOC has filed over 100 criminal complaints in relation to illegally shipped products in the Philippines since 2016. Nearly 2 billion pesos worth of smuggled agricultural products, meanwhile, have been confiscated in the last 3 years.
Quezon City Police hold a simulation exercise as part of security preparations for President Marcos Jr.'s State of the Nation address on Monday. The police department showed off a high-tech robot that will be used to handle suspected bombs. The Philippine National Police also warned arrest for protesters if they hurt authorities providing security for Monday's event. As for the Presidential Security Group, it says it is in its final stages of preparations.
So these preparations are being planned since last week, and that we at PSG, we are prepared in coordination with the Philippine National Police so that everything will run smooth from the time he arrives, he delivers the SONA, until he returns to Malacanang. For now, everything is okay. However, if there are any new information, then we will act on it.
The PNP has declared Commonwealth Avenue a no-rally zone, but militant group Bayan insists the PNP cannot do so and usurp the authority of local officials to grant rally permits. The group adds the SONA should not be militarized and turned into a war zone.